Star Trek Discovery might have just given us one of the most mathematically correct warp jumps in Star Trek history. Warp drive is notoriously inconsistent in Star Trek, despite having a pretty clearly defined scale of warp factors to speeds. Distance, speed, and time estimates are occasionally correct, but usually only in dialogue.
Neptune and back in 6 minutes.
Neptune and back in 6 minutes at warp 4.5 is fairly accurate, but we never see this sort of accuracy in real time in Star Trek. Often, at least one of these things is completely wrong, like in Voyager's Season 1 episode Emanations.
Paris to Janeway. I brought us out of warp. We're 0.6 light years from the ring system.
The ship covers 0.6 light years in mere moments at
warp 7,
a trip that ought to take almost 8 hours. Considering that everybody is exactly where they were at the beginning of the jump, I think it's safe to assume that the edit was meant to reflect real time, and it's really wrong. Another seemingly real-time warp jump can be found in TNG's Season 7 episode Emergence, where the ship travels 30 billion kilometers in about 40 seconds. The warp factor given is
warp 7.3 and holding.
But actually, they'd have to be traveling at warp 9.8, which is technically above the max rating of warp 9.6 for the Galaxy class. And that brings us to Discovery. At the beginning of the episode, Vaulting Ambition, we get a fairly precise distance of
27 million kilometers.
And we get a warp factor.
Engaging engines at warp factor 1.
All that's left is the time involved. Fortunately, we have an unbroken scene of dialogue that is perfectly bookended by engaging and disengaging from warp. That span of time is about 1 minute and 31 seconds. If we do the math, how long should it take a ship at warp factor 1 to travel 27 million kilometers? Remember, warp 1 is the speed of light. Well, it would take 1 minute, 30 seconds. Considering some degree of error from the fact that 27 million kilometers might have been rounded to the nearest million, and or the added amount of time it takes for the shuttle to accelerate to light speed, I think it's safe to say that we're looking at an exceptionally accurate scene, at least by Star Trek standards. Discovery rides an interesting line of embracing some more outlandish concepts like the spore drive, right alongside hard science like using a real drug for a real purpose. But what I appreciate most is when Star Trek manages to be consistent with its own universe. And so far, I think Discovery has done that pretty well, like its awesome demonstration of the Universal Translator, to this most recent attention to detail with consistent and accurate warp speeds. I really hope Discovery has more of this sort of thing in store. What do you think about how Discovery handles its own tech and science? I'd like to hear your thoughts. I want to keep making Star Trek videos for a long time to come, and if you guys like my work, consider supporting me on Patreon. I'd like to thank all of you who already support the channel there every month. It goes a long way toward ensuring the future of this channel. To the rest of you, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.